watch yourself on Facebook, because there is truly anger and hatred, not on one part, but on a lot of parts. And people can become addicted to that negativity. And if you are a Facebook person or communicator on that level, you may find yourself entering that world and losing yourself in that, because there's so much out there. There really is in this society today. And you see it play out in real time. My favorite saying comes from Shakespeare, who I truly believe was his Zen master sometimes. And he said, the better part of valor is discretion. And it goes back to what you're saying about, it's a situation by situation kind of thing. You've got to choose how you want to engage. Do you want to engage? And at times, the consequence. Because the one thing about anger, and the Buddha speaks, and all the great Buddhist masters speak of anger as being the precursor to a lot of other experiences. And if you read some of the suttas, he often talks about, with anger, it's a matter of being patient, of waiting, and having the wisdom to know when to engage, when not to engage, especially as your question about if somebody's standing and holding a gun, please don't engage it. The other thing is, in an open carry state as we are in, you've got to make some determinations about what your beliefs are and who you are, when you want to engage and when you don't want to engage, when you can speak in peace and sometimes not saying anything is the wisest path. Even Gandhi, who's one of my heroes, once said, first they laugh at you, then they attack you, and then you win. And I always keep that in mind, because people are going at each other nowadays, calling each other names, and there is no dialogue. And if you're going to engage in that, one of the things I would suggest is to look at your end game. To let your neighbor know that even if you disagree with them, that there's a goodness there in how you choose to end that conversation or get out of that conversation sometimes with both people intact. And that goes to what Don was talking about, meta. If I get into a situation with somebody who's on the opposite side, I may end up finding myself getting beat up verbally. And that's not meta. I may end up beating up on them verbally. And that's not meta. I was first, when I was a kid in 62, I was going to school, Catholic school, and the morning I woke up on the news, a Buddhist monk had put himself on fire in South Vietnam and engaged Buddhism. And I looked at that monk and I felt compassion for him. And I thought to myself, this man is a saint. But when I went to school, because the kids didn't understand, there was a real uneasiness about the group. And what I thought was so cool, the nuns at the school were talking about this and talking about that there was to be no fun made of these people. There was nobody to go off on these people. And 2 days later, the Prime Minister of Vietnam's wife came on TV and said that these monks were useless. They were no good, they were not good for Vietnam. But the monks, like Thich Nhat Hanh, would prove that to be different. If you fast forward to the
end. If I could just say something here about my own experience, I